Hello and welcome to the Q School Final. My name is Luke Elvey and my co-pilot today is John McCarthy. Howdy, John.
Oh, hello, Luke.
Delighted to be alongside you too, John. The yoga's been done, feeling stretched and ready to go. Can't wait to see what is delivered out on the course.
And there you have it, folks. First drive of the event. This is looking fairway bound. He'll be happy with that. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And after the first hole, starting the round at one under par. This one's looking pretty good so far. And from about 120 yards out. This one's definitely heading towards the green. And about 17 feet to the cup. Oh my gracious, that was close. And tapping in for par. And to set up one under for the day. The third hole tee up. Just a magnificent display of power here. Going with the 3-wood. This is heading towards the green. Okay, hitting this par 5 in 2 is going to set up some definite eagle possibilities. Oh my goodness, that was close. This putt's about 3 feet away. And that putt will drop the birdie. Change ranking wise after that hole. And now the fourth hole. And going with the 9-iron. Well, not a very great approach shot there. Didn't have enough club on that one. And this putt, it's a par. This shot is looking too good. And that one will drop the putt. And currently sitting at 2 under for the day. Okay, and here is the fifth hole. And just a huge drive here. From 120 yards out. Well, this one's still quite far away, but it is definitely on the green. Oh, and it just didn't drop. And this putt's for par. And after that one, nothing's changing here. He's still tied for first. And moving on to the sixth here. And nicely done. Looking like we'll have some fairway here. And this putt is for birdie. Ooh, and that was very close. This one's about 7 feet away. Just missing. A miss for the bogey. Okay, and now we will take a look at the leaderboard. And we will fall out of first place after that one. And he's not going to like that. The next hole we have before us is a par three. Let's see what happens. And that looks like a five iron. This could be good. It's heading for the green here. And about 17 feet left to go. Just missing here. This one's for par. And after that hole, staying fast in the second place on the leaderboard. And next on the plate is the eighth hole. Well, I think this one's going to find the short grass. And here's an eight iron. And this one's heading towards the green. And this for the birdie. And about 8 feet to the cup. Ooh, just misses. And this one is for the bogey. And good putt. And after that hole, that's going to put him up to even par. And he's currently tied for fourth up on the leaderboard. And on to the ninth hole. Phenomenal power on that one. Taking a shot with the pitching wedge. Well, this is definitely heading towards the green. All right, and he's on. This one's about 6 feet away. For the birdie. All right, Luke, we're nine holes into this final round. What's on your mind? What are you seeing from your vantage point today?
Well, John, it's looking good for them out there. If they keep playing this way, I'm pretty sure we'll see them on the web.com tour very soon.
Thanks, Luke. Now let's get back to it. And let's see what the 10th has in store. Uh-oh, this is not going to be good. And I think he will be happy with that. And this one's for birdie. And this one's about 19 feet away. This could be the shot, folks. And oh my, what a putt that was. Very long putt, right into the cup. It looks like he moved down on the leaderboard after that one. And moving on to the 11th hole. And nothing wrong with that shot. Going with the 8 iron. This one's looking pretty good. That shot will be on the green with a fair amount of distance to make up to get that next putt in the hole. Looking like 8 feet to the cup here. Finishing this hole with a solid putt. And no change in the standings after that hole. Off on this par three. It looks like a 7 iron. The shot may be a bit long, folks. Well, turns out that one is safely on the green. This putt's for birdie. putt is for par. And that one will drop. And after that hole, he will stay at even par. And he's currently tied for fourth place in the leaderboard. It's looking like it's heading into the fairway. And here's the three wood. And this one's looking pretty good. Nice shot. I think they like that. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And that one will go for 30. And he will move up on the leaderboard after that hole. And setting up now on the 14th tee. And that was a powerful, powerful drive. Yeah, it looks like a 5-iron. This one's looking good. Okay, 31 feet out. And folks, I think this shot's looking too good. Ooh, that would have been good. And for the par. That he will move into a tie for first. And setting up now on the 15th. I think we'll find some fairway here. It looks like the hybrid is on display here. It's going towards the green here. Okay, and hitting this par 5 and 2, that's some fine club work out there. Ooh, I thought that was going to go. And a little bit of bad luck there. And it's about 3 feet to the cup from here. And that par putt will drop. And after that hole, 1 under for the day. And setting up on the 16th tee. This one's looking good, folks. And this one's about 3 feet from the cup. Will drop for par. And after that, he will fall out of first place. Okay, moving on to the 17th now. And this shot's looking promising. Wow, and just a fantastic drive, hitting the green in one. Feet away here for the birdie, and he is going to move up and into first place. And moving on to the 18th hole, well, this one's looking like it's in the fairway. Shot's looking pretty good. Well, that approach is definitely on, and there's fairways still to get to that hole. And folks, this could be the one. Oh, almost dropping that long one. And tapping in to end the round with a par. And this could be the start of something spectacular, Luke. Capping the Q School final off with a win, no doubt qualifies them to play in the Web.com Tour next season.
I really like the look of this player, John. I think they've got a bright future. I really feel the web.com tour is just a stepping stone to a big career. Well, on behalf of John McCarthy, I'm Luke Elvey. Hope you enjoyed today's coverage.